always thought when I got married that my life would be a whirl. Then I discovered I've married a boy who'd rather be a girl. I met him one night in Miami, and I wed him one night in Miami. His name was Tommy, but he said, call me Tammy. 'Twas then I knew he'd rather be a girl. Oh, I recall when we tied the knot. He said, I do, but he didn't say what. And I noticed he danced with the best man a lot. The best man's name was Pearl. Oh, why did I wed a gay pretender who doesn't do what is on the groom's agenda? How in the world can I surrender to a boy who wears my negligee? He cooks for me and he sews for me. He even mends my hose for me. But he never curls my toes for me like a boy should do a girl. You should see the queer things that he does. Now he's modeling my jewels and my furs. And our towels are all marked hers and hers. And I'm getting real confused. He looks like a boy and he acts like a boy. He's positively stacked like a boy. But in the boudoir he don't attack like a boy. He'd rather do his hair. Oh, it hurts me down deep inside, 'cause I don't really feel like I'm a bride. And the zipper on his pants is on the side. Now don't that prove he'd rather be a girl? Oh, I have offered him my everything, my furs and my jewels and my diamond ring. I said, do right by me, you can be a king, but he'd rather be a queen. Now, honestly, I'm very broad-minded, and I take my love where I can find it. But all he does is pantomime it, and this I can't enjoy. This is really a catastrophe. This capon's no good for a chick like me. I guess that I'll just have to set him free, for what else can I do? Now maybe you folks cannot observe this, but a gal who isn't getting service starts walking around mighty nervous. Gotta get him out of my life. I'll find some place where I can send him. I'll even go as far as to recommend him. He'll make some boy a dog.